This is the one who was with the Empress when she died. Poisoned. Tivian stuff.
Amateur work. He'll live.
That's up to Dowd.
I know a great deal, bodyguard. I recognize those marks on your hand. A gift from your friend. The one who talks to you in the dark. Talks to you when you visit his shrines. I visited those shrines too. And I know what it felt like to shovel blade into your Empress. But I don't know you. Who you are, and who you fight for. They're a mystery, and I can't allow that.
Here you are at last, in a ruined and drowning world. Held captive by the man who killed your Empress, the assassin, Dowd. Your friends poisoned you and dumped your body in the river. Did they do it to protect themselves, so no one would ever know what they'd done? Or was it because they were a single move away from controlling an empire, and they knew you'd never let them manipulate Emily? Maybe none of these. Perhaps that's just the nature of man.
Thank you.
come back here?
Hard to say, but we should watch the streets. We'll see him from the rooftops.
All right. If nothing else, you can cut him off at the market.
He can't get through the rail station without the key.
This one is resourceful. He'll find a way.
Thank you.
Master.
May I not have a moment of...
Thorpe, beaten us, sir. He's killed men who have no evil.
See how you fare against my assassin. And now we fight a duel that no two others could fight against the ticking of the clock. Another slice out of time. I have one more surprise for you. I asked for my life when I killed your empress and took her daughter. Something broke inside me. Now I see the design on the back of your hand, the mark of the outsider himself. And I remember all I've done. The years of waiting for the right moment to step forward from an alley and drive a knife between...
are you? Are you some new kind of guard? Like a tall boy? Can't be. Doctor, maybe? Just kidding. Assassin, maybe. Passing through, huh? Hoping to catch a ride on the plague wagon. A few come through here trying. And they fall and break their necks, but that won't stop you. You're almost there. It's pretty easy to get to the rooftops from here. You'll see the way.
Anything. I must be in a basement.
There's no hospital. I told you that.
I can't stand this waiting anymore. Plague wagon's running every couple of minutes now.
Now they're saying the Lord Regent started the plague himself.
I don't understand.
Thank you. I wish I had a last swig of whiskey. You're the mask guy's been taking down all the lords and ladies. No way through this gate unless you've got the sewer key. Only one place to get that key, and I wouldn't go there. Not for all the gold in Dunwall Tower. Not again. Maybe you could pull it off, though. Something attacked us in the distillery. It used the rats. I know it sounds crazy. And then it run back under the streets. So we come down here to kill it. Slackjaw leading the way. Went bad. I barely crawled out. Don't know what happened to Slackjaw. He had the sewer key, though.
Thank you. I'm going to boil off the nasty fat and sit and die a pretty song.
Hey! Someone kill this crazy witch! I can make you rich!
Quiet now. Granny needs to come. Oh, no. I'll and cook you an inch. Get him! He wants to hurt Granny. Then who will care for you? You think you're going to save him?
Want to know something funny? When we were kids, we were all scared of Granny Rags. Thought she was a terrible witch. Then we grew up and figured she was just a sad old lady. We were right the first time. Now ain't that funny?
I owe you. This won't even the score, but it's all I got left. Luck to you, Corvo.
Find your way into such interesting places, Corvo. At the eye of the storm, raging between Granny Rags and this man who has lived his whole life with a cleaver in one hand and a bottle in the other. Crawling out of those flooded ruins, winding your way back to the pub where you last saw Emily. Where is she now? How does it feel now, knowing your allies betrayed you? Strange how there's always a little more innocence left to lose. And Dowd, the man who killed the Empress. You had him in the palm of your hand, and you let him walk away? You fascinate me.
No! Oh, it's you, Corvo. Thank the stars. We all thought you'd been killed. Except for Samuel. He seemed sure you'd survived. I saw him on the river shortly before the killing began. He was smart enough not to come ashore. But I'll bet he's still out there. Looking for you is my guess. Havelock called us into the yard. But I wasn't feeling well. I just watched from the attic. The Admiral brought his cutlass. He stuck Wallace through the eye with it. Then he did Lydia. Callista he shot in the back with his pistol. Emily saw it all. Havelock kept yelling something about the things he'd done and how no one could ever know. Pendleton wouldn't even look anyone in the face. They said it was time for Sokolov and went off to his cage. I don't know what happened after that. Emily was there when the killing started. I thought Lydia would squeal on me at the end. She just told Havelock to screw himself. And died.
What a day, huh? Gonna be a great party tonight. I was only a kid at the last coronation. If we even make it to tonight. Will you look at this mess?
Relax. One of the officers said he was dead. Poisoned, thrown in the river. If you ask me, he's long gone. Threw the mask in the river, left out.
That's what a rational person would do. Not this guy. You have to understand the criminal mind. I hear they had to hide the Caldwell girl from him the whole time they were working with him. I heard they locked him in a cage and only let him out at night.
The criminal mind, huh? So what's he doing now?
Waiting. He's probably watching us right now.
Update.
Our men are still trying to penetrate the workshop. Close up tight. We think Piero Joplin's inside.
Get up right now. We'll find him. Hey, wake up. Hear me? Here you are. Take it.
With someone on my own level.
Couldn't agree more. Your expulsion from the Academy was a crime against natural philosophy itself.
Which you might have pointed out at the time. But it's pointless to hold a grudge. I want to ask you.
About the elixir, yes. And I need to discuss your tonic. Why have you not tried the homeopathic solution?
And where am I to find the subjects? I can't recruit from prisons as you do. But it's forced me to work with another agent derived from...
The river crusts, yes. I'd guessed as much. But I think our approaches may reinforce each other. This is what we've been lacking thus far. Corvo, good to see that you still breathe. The city would not be the same if you were not with us. I've completed Piero's work on an arc pylon, but only just.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious or they can be reduced to ashes. I've attuned it so that we will be safe from the functions of the device. It will only trigger in the presence of our enemies. This arc pylon is more powerful than the older design. It will function at a greater range, striking down our foes while ignoring us. I need my final sequence, which is recorded in the blueprint for this device. Havelock was inspecting it before the killing started. Return the blueprint to me. It was in his bedroom before he left. Hopefully, it's still there. You may navigate the fields of battle. Astonishing! The arc pylon is complete. Now to activate it.
With this device, we can send a powerful electrical signal through the nervous system, merely rendering our enemies unconscious, or they can be reduced to ashes.
What is your opinion, Corvo? As you wish, Corvo. We will be far away before any of them regain their senses. All is ready, Corvo. All that remains is plugging in a whale oil tank to power it. Will you do the honors?
When this arc pylon is charged, no one will dare come near us.
Beyond my greatest expectations. It defies description. A device like this will ensure Dunwall's security for a century.
Well, Corvo, I hope we can be considered colleagues again. You were condemned, I was kidnapped. Men like us rise above such things. As to the good Admiral, I believe men such as Havelock start with high-minded intentions. Same with Martin, and maybe even Pendleton, though I suspect he was just lazy. But no one is prepared for the sheer seductive influence of being so close to real power. Once you start ordering people killed to get your way, everything else is mere detail. I return to my work now, and you to yours. Killing people, I mean. I sincerely hope it goes well. This Piero of yours, a strange mind. But then my own is strange as well. If there is a cure to the plague, I believe we will find it. The old Empress would have liked that. She was a strange one. Stranger, I think, than you ever knew. But such things are past. And this new Empress, she's a strange one too. I wish you peace, Corvo, along with all the delights you can wring from the world.
claims were accurate. Conspiracy, just a nest of worms. All is falling to ruin, and even the great Piero's days are numbered as hounds scratch at his door. If only I had enough whale oil in here to set off a pyre equal to my brilliance.
We once discussed a system of signals to be used in Emily's tower for communication across the river. I wonder if he remembers that. I'll do what you want, but ask quickly. Goodbye, Corvo. I wish to apologize for what was done to you. It seems that holding all the pieces and standing a step from the throne changed something in the others. Something I don't understand. Don't underestimate Havelock, Corvo. He'll be waiting.
I'm devastated. The girl I've been caring for is gone. Emily is her name. Yes, that Emily. Daughter to the Empress. She's gone. They took her away in a boat this morning. I don't know where, and her hair hadn't been combed. I worry who will look after her. I didn't even get a chance to say goodbye.